Miss! 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 Miss,
Austen.
Mr. Lefroy.
Yes, I know, but I'm alone.
Except for me?
Exactly.
Well, what rules of conduct apply in these rural situations? We were introduced at your reading, were we not?
What value is there in introducing when you cannot remember my name? These scruples must seem very provincial to a gentleman with such elevated airs. But I do not devise these rules, I am merely obliged to obey them.
I've been told there was much to see on a walk. But all I have detected so far is a general tendency to green above and brown below.
Yes. Well, others have detected more. It is celebrated. There is even a book about Selborne Wood.
Oh. A novel, perhaps?
Novels. Being poor, insipid things, read by mere women, even, God forbid, written by mere women.
I see. We're talking of your reading.
As of the writing of women, it did not display the greatest knowledge of human nature, the liveliest effusions of wit and humour, and the best chosen language imaginable.
Was I deficient in rapture?
In consciousness.
It was accomplished.
It was ironic.
And you're sure I haven't offended you?
Not at all!
Good. Miss Austen.
Mr. Lefroy. And reading?
Yes. So I've been looking through your book of the wood. Mr. White's Natural History.
And how do you like it?
I cannot get on. It's too disturbing.
Disturbing?
Take this observation. Swifts, on a fine morning in May, flying this way and that way, sailing around at a great height, perfectly happily. Then, one leaps onto the back of another, grasps tightly, and forgetting to fly, they both sink down and down in a great, dying fall. Fathom after fathom, until the female utters.
Yes.
The female utters a loud, piercing cry of ecstasy. Tell me, is this conduct commonplace in the natural history of Hampshire? Heard of Mr. Wisley's proposal. My congratulations.
Is there any alternative for a well-educated young woman of small fortune?
How can you marry him? Even with his houses, and its thousands. How can you, of all people, dispose of yourself without affection?
How can I dispose of myself with it? You are leaving tomorrow. Did I do that well?
Very. Very well indeed.
I wanted just for once to do it well.
I have no money, no property. I'm entirely dependent upon that bizarre old lunatic, my uncle. I cannot yet offer you marriage, but you must know how I feel. Jane, I'm yours. I'm yours. I'm yours, heart and soul. Much good that is.
Let me decide that.
What must we do?
What we must.